Hey everybody, this is Ranchin bringing you another StarCraft commentary. This is going to be the set that was played on the 17th of November between STX Seoul and Lakehef Oz. This is the first set, and it's going to be between Cal and Backho, two Protoss players. Oh boy. Cal is known for his surprise rise back in the year to the MSL Finals, where he got trounced by Jadong. And Backho is known for, well, all, for some reason, making it far in Star Leagues and then getting his ass kicked. And for some reason, fangirls really like to draw feminine pictures of him. And he likes to dress up as girls and dance. That's a fact, I'm not joking. So we're going to have a PvP here. Give me a sec here to count down. 4, 3, 2, 1, go. This is a PvP, and actually, none of these players are very good PvP, unfortunately. Cal has a record of under 50%, but thankfully Backho also has a record of under 50%. So, unfortunately, Backho overall has a win rate under 50%. He's not that good against Protoss, he's worse against Zerg, he's alright against Terrans. That's his only positive. Cal is actually very good against Terrans and Zergs, both win percents of 60%. His Protoss, Protoss is, you know, mediocre, just under 50. This map is Destination, a very interesting 1v1 map, where you have a very long distance between spawn points. So this map is pretty much, you know, very mean to Zergs. Terrans and Protoss overall kick ass here. The very long distance helps Protoss very much because, you know, it lets them take their time to build up. And overall, you know, doesn't allow the rest, the other races to go for a quick rush. There are huge bridges in the middle, which basically, you know, you control the bridges, you control the map. Well, this is why it helps Terrans, but in Protoss, you know, they let large troop movements and large battles in the middle, which is a lot of fun. The expansions are fairly easy to hold if you do it properly. I mean, there's just a small ramp leading down to your natural, and from then on you can pretty much just move out. So yeah, both finally scouting. We're going to have, forgot to mention this, we're going to have Backho in green on the bottom, and we're going to have Cal in, we're going to have, yeah, Cal in purple or violet on the bottom, and Cal and Backho in green on the top. Wow, I am not myself today. To recount that again, Cal in green. No, Backho in green on the top and Cal in purple on the bottom. And Backho already going for a little bit of harass there while he set up his gateway and going for an assimilator right away. Same here with Cal. And there he goes, Backho's doing a little trouble with that green probe of his. Probes are actually, you know, the most resilient workers. And he gets taken down by the Zealot running right into him. But, you know, Cal's probe still running around, scatting out, causing some trouble. Both guys going for some pretty standard openings. Pile on into gateway, and there you go. Backho going for a quick cybernetics core, and same for Cal. So we have mirror build so far. It's after the CC that I'm wondering if they will diverge. Maybe one of them will go for two gateways, the other maybe go for robotics facility, or both can go for robotics facility, or even both can go for two gateways. But usually in PvP, you see at least one of the players go for a quit robotics facility in order to get that Reaver out and get that Reaver harass going early. Zealot from Cal moving up, seeing if he can cause some trouble, seeing as how Backho Zealot is distracted. But yeah, he does get into the base, gets met by another Zealot. But, you know, if Cal manages to macro his Zealot and probe well, he might be able to take down a probe before he himself gets taken up by those two Zealots. Run around, cause some trouble, that's kind of the point of this early kind of base harass. And this keeps Backho inside his base, doesn't allow him to send out a scout meanwhile himself. He just has to kind of stay around, make sure that Zealot and that probe doesn't cause too much trouble. No manor pylons, and nothing like that. Apparently though, Cal is going to keep his probe inside, but going to move his Zealot back home. Seeing it, yeah, there you go. He's pretty damaged. You just want to keep on. Hey, shot of Toss Girl, who has very recently been promoted back to the back. I don't know, but has been promoted to the A team, to the B team, and she's now sitting there somewhere, probably with her boyfriend. Calm, go calm. Come on, she's hot. So there we go. Backhoe going for the second gateway, and already with a Dragoon out. Upgrading a Goon range as well. He might be trying to move out, see what kind of damage he can do. Cal with his gateway up and going for a quick Nexus. Why did I not mention this just a second ago? So he can be in trouble here if Backhoe pushes in. He only has two Zealots to defend. No Dragoon. There we go. First Dragoon out, but he's moving up towards Cal's base and towards Backhoe's base, but that's not going to be able to do anything. Just going to check those guys. See? Yep, they're there and probably not going to press it. Probably be a stupid idea. Takes one shot and just going to move back. Although Backhoe could do some harass. I mean, I still think the Nexus will come up just fine. Second gateway and a robot after the robotics facility up for Cal. So he's going to have a slightly faster Reaver. Although fewer forces and a slight weak time right now. But if Backhoe doesn't push it, I mean, then Cal will be able to have a good economy. And there he goes. Scouting for a gunner. Is he going to see it? I can't tell, but I think there's a good chance that he actually saw the Nexus, so he's going to push out now, try to push on Cal while he still can, because Cal has lesser defenses. Oh, there we go, see that? And they're not showing whether he saw. He's just focusing on a scouting probe instead of going and pushing in. What's wrong with you, Backhoe? Oh man, there's a slight window that's still open, and if Backhoe does not push in and take advantage, Cal will be able to get up a strong economy and basically push in. Cal's just waiting outside. Backhoe just waiting outside Cal's base. Going also for his Nexus. So he decides, you know what, hell, I'm not going to push in. I'm just going to plop down the Nexus myself, get my economy going. Keep the romping game and possibly go in for a contain here. And there you go, moving in. Five Dragoons, two Zealots. Cal has to move his probes out to help against this. Only four Dragoons and one Zealot. One Zealot goes down for Cal, and one Dragoon goes down for Cal. Another Dragoon is going to go down. More Dragoons out for Backhoe. Probes helping out, but Dragoons more popping out. Backhoe has plenty of Dragoons. Probes trying to help and block, but can't be too many Dragoons in for Backhoe. Probes dying, and Dragoons dying, and more Dragoons moving in for Backhoe. They're going to take down a bunch of probes, going to take down Dragoons, and oh man, Observer now out for Cal, not that it's going to help much. Backhoe moving in with even more Dragoons, taking some a serious lead right here. Plenty of Dragoons just pumping down on that Nexus. Should be able to take it out unless Cal moves out quickly. Yes, Dragoons blocking his ramp, and a couple of Dragoons and probes blocking his ramp, but oh man, he trying to prevent Backhoe from going in. Backhoe could either go for a push or just take down the Nexus calmly outside, because not going to do anything. Plops down three more gateways. Nexus going down, so he's going to be able to simply just takes down Cal's Nexus. He's going to be able to just now either go for a slight push or just macro up heavy, and then just when he finally gets enough forces, push in and take them all out. Oh man, Cal forced to move out even more pros for blocking, and Cal, Backhoe can just stay outside Cal's base, moving in even more Dragoons, can just stay out there and just bip bidi 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 bidi. I'm just going to wait until I get a much better economy and can just push in on Cal. Oh boy, bad start right here for Cal. I mean, neither play is really known for their PvT, but this is not a good start. Cal, mostly known for his creativity. Backhoe, I don't know. I mean, he's a young guy. Probably, you know, also, you know, young players are known for being creative. I mean, that's really the only reason I see Backhoe actually being capable of getting to round of 8 and round of 16s of a lot of Star Leagues. Robotic support going down for Backhoe. I haven't seen it yet for Best. He's gonna need Reaver support if he's gonna try to go down that ramp again. Yeah, robotic support had already been actually up for a while, so he's just waiting for his Reaver to plop into the shuttle. He has to be very careful with that shuttle, because if the shuttle with the Reaver goes down without doing anything against Backhoe's forces out there, he's going to be screwed. He's already so far behind. His economy is going to get far behind because Backhoe is already mining from his expansion. He has plenty of Dragoons around to protect against any drops. He knows that this is what usually, you know, you're behind him economy, you get rid of the economy of the opponent. That's standard strategy. Oh boy, I don't know how Cal can really come back for this one. he has one base, he's mining for him, he doesn't have... And wow! Okay, Backhoe simply just moved back, is gonna allow Cal to simply just move out and take back his expansion. Although, you know, if he doesn't, if Backhoe believes he doesn't have enough forces, it can actually be a decent move. He could just micro up for a little while and then go for a decisive push before Cal gets allowed to catch up. And even if Cal caught up, it would be some serious macro slash micro that's gonna take to win this game. You have to really focus down on his Reavers, and Cal moving out to good.